Let us check whatever we have implemented so far in the mandatory field validation in the name field. I am clicking within the field and then clicking outside the field. The validation error message for mandatory field is displayed. If I type something, the error message disappears. If I clear the content, the error message gets displayed. Let me now demonstrate a different scenario. I am reloading the page using the reload icon available in the browser. I am typing some characters in the input text field and then clearing whatever typed. Now the mandatory field validation error message should be displayed as the field is empty, but the error message is not displayed. We can see touched is false and invalid is true. As one of the condition becomes false and operator is used, the entire condition becomes false and the error message is not displayed. In other words, the field is not yet touched, hence it is not displaying the message. This scenario can be handled using dirty property available in the NgModel object. Dirty is a Boolean property that becomes true when user makes any modifications in the form field content. Let us see how the dirty property works. I am copying and pasting the lines that displays the touched and untouched property. I am clearing touched label and changing it as dirty, then changing the property as dirty. Similarly, clearing untouched label and changing it as pristine, then changing the property as pristine. The opposite of dirty property is pristine. The word pristine means something that stays in original condition and not yet spoiled. The pristine in a text field means that the data in the field is in original state and not yet modified. After these changes, I am saving the file. After the page reload, we can see that the initial property of dirty is false and pristine is true, which means that we have not made any changes in the data of the input text field. In the text field, let me type a character, after which we can see dirty changed to true and pristine changed to false. Once the state changes to dirty, it will remain dirty until the page is freshly shown again. Now we can use dirty property to handle the scenario mentioned in the start of this video. In the ngif directive, I am including or operator after touched followed by namefield.dirty. Here AND operator takes precedence, so dirty and invalid is what will be compared first. This makes invalid property completely taking control of the expression, and the outcome of this expression will be based on the value of invalid property. To avoid this, I am including touched and dirty within brackets so that it takes precedence over the AND operator. The condition now means that if the field is either touched or dirty, and if it is invalid, then the validation error message needs to be displayed. Let me now save the file. After the page reload, I am first going to check if it is working correctly when the field is touched. I am clicking within the field and then clicking outside the field, the message gets displayed, so the scenario implemented in the previous video is working correctly. Now let me try the scenario I tried in the beginning of this video. Let me reload the page. Let me type something in the field, then I am clearing whatever was typed. We can now see the error message displayed, which was not getting displayed earlier. Hope this helps to understand how dirty property helps to implement validation when the user haven't moved out of the field but has done some changes in the field. Let me summarize the changes to be done in app.component.html. In the ngif directive, change the condition to include dirty property. include these two lines to view the values of dirty and pristine properties. Check if the dirty property works as demonstrated in this video, then move on to the next video.